I'm so glad it's almost over. Congratulations, sweetie.
Thank you.
I'll never understand why you chose such a macabre field.
There's nothing disturbing about it. It's just that
I'm proud of you. I really am. You've come so far. So, you haven't told me what's next. Will you get a job where you are, or...?
They actually have everyone they need. But my old teacher, Mr. Delver, transferred me to his office to finalize my internship there.
Oh, well, that's good. I remember you mentioning him. Where's he located? Are you moving away from me?
No, I'm not moving. He's actually located around here. River Fields.
Oh, Rebecca. I don't like that.
Grandma.
Even I've heard things about that place. I'd just be worried
people
about you.
People make up stories. Death is a scary thing to a lot of people. And we try to explain things we don't understand, and we want comfort when we lose someone we love. I mean, no one's embalming any ghost bodies or whatever. It's fine.
Right. I'm sorry. But I wanted to give you this anyway. So, here.
I don't know if I want that.
Just take it, please. It should be yours anyway.
Thanks.
All right, enough spooky stuff. I'm so proud of you. When is all this happening? When do you start?
I've actually been there for a few weeks now. My review is tomorrow. Here we go. I don't have my clipboard. I can't use that here.
Rebecca, great, perfect timing. I just finished with Mr. Dalton here. Please wheel him back to cold storage and bring us Mrs. Page. All right, I'm just finishing up something here, so why don't you grab the clipboard and start recording identifying marks. I'll get out of your way when you're done and let you hop in here. These old windows never stay latched. Great. Climb on in here and put everything into the record system. Don't forget to take the printout to the front desk so Zoe can add it to the packet for the family. After that, we'll get started. You'll die here.
What was that?
I didn't say anything. You all right?
Yeah, I'm fine. Sorry. Time to embalm.
All right. I've set everything out so you can just go ahead and get started. I'll be monitoring. Everything's on your list there if you need it.
Can't hold anything else. I can't use that here. I can't use that here. I can't use that here. There we go. All right. I can't hold anything else. Can't hold anything else. I can't use that here.
Sometimes we get chemicals that haven't been stored properly, and it can make them pop like that. Just keep doing your thing. I'll get it.
I'm missing something. Can't hold anything else. I can't use that here. I can't use that here. I'm missing something. I can't use that here. There we go.
Tell you what.
What?
Why don't you go ahead and head out? I'll take over from here.
Are you sure? I just got here.
Don't worry. You're doing great. I'll get the last of your paperwork sorted today and call you in for your first shift. Go ahead. It's fine. I'll give you a call when we get someone in.
It was just really weird.
So some stuff fell over. That's not a big deal.
No, I know. It wasn't even my fault, but he sent me home right after that. I'm just really worried. He was supposed to finalize my stuff today.
And he said he would, right?
Yeah.
So that's a good thing.
Yeah, it just didn't feel like he meant it. Like, he just said it to get me out of the building. Wait a sec, I have another call. Hello?
Hey, Rebecca. It's Raymond.
Oh, hi, Mr. Delver. Look, if I did anything wrong today, just...
No. I wanted to apologize. You've done a fantastic job. I'm just not feeling too well. That's actually why I'm calling. I know it's late, but we just got 3 new cadavers, and no one else can make it in right now. I was hoping you could come in and take care of them.
Well, yeah. Are you sure? I mean, of course.
Excellent. You're doing me a huge favor. I took care of the rest of your onboarding. We're all set. And your new badge is in your personal belongings drawer in the back room.
That's great. Thank you. I'm on my way right now. I hope you feel better.
Thanks again. I'll see you tomorrow.
Bye. Holy shit! That was him. He signed me on. He needs me to come in tonight.
See? I told you it was fine. Congratulations.
Thanks. I have to go, like, right now. I'll talk to you later. Where are my keys? All right, guess I'll head to the back and get started. Mr. Delver, I need help. Someone's outside the mortuary.
Just try to stay calm. I know you're scared. I'll unlock the door in a moment.
What?
This is very sudden, but listen to me. We have to start right away. I'm sorry. I didn't know until it made itself known this morning that it was here, let alone bound to you. I had no way of knowing the possession had started.
What? Look, this isn't funny. Stop.
You need to take this seriously. You need to act quickly.
This is insane. I'll just leave. I'll just fucking leave.
You can't leave, Rebecca. I can't allow that for you or for others. It's far too dangerous.
What am I supposed to do then?
Most bodies I work with at night are fine. So we stay calm. Okay? We embalm, file the paperwork, everything. Treat it like a normal day. Staying focused will help. I left some things for you on the desk. I'll call again when you get to the embalming room.
No, wait. Ugh, damn it, what the fuck? This is insane. Okay, this is so stupid. It's just some hazing for the new girl or something. Just play along and do your job. Quitting tomorrow. I mean, who does something like this?
That's not it.
All right, listen carefully.
I'm sorry, but this entire thing is extremely unprofessional. If this is how you treat new hires, I don't think I can work for you. This isn't funny.
Rebecca, you don't have to believe me, but I hope you do before it's too late. The only way to save yourself is to banish the demon before you're too far gone. To do that, you will need to learn the demon's name, bind it to its chosen body, and burn it in the retort. Look, I know this is a lot to take in. I wish I could do more for you. I had years to learn what I know. You have hours. I've recorded a number of cassettes to instruct you in the hope that having a physical object with a known message will help you stay grounded. I won't be calling again. You can't trust the phones. Anything can be manipulated. Listen to the tapes. Learn the demon's name. Burn the correct body. The most important thing in the room is in that cabinet. Open it up. Good luck, Rebecca. I'm sorry this had to happen.
This is insane. Whatever. Just be the professional one, grab a body, and get started.
Shift database, a computer program combining all my findings into one reference point. The database contains all the information on the process of expulsion, the tools. tools used, and most importantly, all the markings of the known demonic names. If you ever forget what to do, replay these tapes or look it up in the database. The collection of demonic names is the most crucial piece to the puzzle. You will need this information. My ID card is in my personal belongings drawer. On the back is the passcode to access it. Use it.
Let's check you out. At least I can keep track of things. Hello? Nope, nope. New job. I'm getting out of here. Screw this. I'm getting back to work. So stupid. There we go. I need to file the copy up front. Time to embalm. I can't use that here. I'm missing something. I'm missing something. There we go. All right. Thank you.
Banish a demon to hell. It must be bound to its chosen body and burned. The three objects in this cabinet are your tools. First, the clay tablet in the center is called a mark. Placing the smaller pieces in the correct configuration will spell the demon's name. Second, the bottles on the top shelf are a special reagent that will react to the mark. Add a bottle to the embalming mixture during the process. When the mark is placed on the correct body with the reagent inside, it will force the demon to become bound to it. Pay attention to signs that you have chosen correctly. They can be obvious or extremely subtle. Once you are certain the demon is bound to its vessel, burn it. Finally, the pieces of paper on the right are called letting strips. It must inscribe the sigils of its name in our world to begin the evocation. You will need to uncover these sigils to use them. Hold a letting strip up while wandering the mortuary. If it begins to smolder and burn, you're close. When the paper combusts, the sigil has been revealed somewhere in that area. They can be anywhere. So look on walls, under objects, inside furniture. Anywhere. The demon will inscribe its sigils over time to try and hide them, so check regularly. Once you uncover the sigils, use the night shift database to decide which demon you're dealing with, and use that knowledge to create the mark. The steps are simple. Add the reagent to the embalming mixture. Uncover the sigils. Build the mark and place it on the body. Then, when you're certain, burn it in the retort. Thank you. Identifying a demonic entity is a delicate balance. The further you are from possession, the more time you have. The closer you are, the more the demon will make itself known, allowing you the information to guess its name and the body it's bound to. The only way I've found to tell how far along a possession is on your own is to scribble on a piece of paper. Don't think about it. Just scribble. Look carefully. If you notice anything strange, it's starting to take hold. There's a notepad and a pencil on the desk in the front room. Checking from time to time can give an idea of how long you might have.
You should have fucking died. I will slit your eyes open, and your last vision as they wither will be of the flesh being peeled from your legs, and all that will be left is eternal pain and darkness. You will beg me to take your pathetic carcass.
Do you notice anything strange? It's starting to take hold.
Jesus Christ.
To banish a demon to hell, it must be bound to its chosen body and burned. The three objects in this cabinet are your tools. First, the clay tablet in the center is called a mark. Placing the smaller pieces in the correct configuration will spell the demon's name. Second, the bottles on the top shelf are a special reagent that will react to the mark. Add a bottle to the embalming mixture during the process. When the mark is placed on the correct body, with the reagent inside, it will force the demon to become bound to it. Pay attention to signs that you have chosen correctly. They can be obvious or extremely subtle. Once you are certain the demon is bound to its vessel, burn it. Finally, the pieces of paper on the right are called letting strips. It must inscribe the sigils of its name in our world to begin the evocation. You will need to uncover these sigils to use them. Hold a letting strip up while wandering the mortuary. If it begins to smolder and burn, you're close. When the paper combusts, the sigil has been revealed somewhere in that area. They can be anywhere. So look on walls, under objects, inside furniture. Anywhere. The demon will inscribe its sigils over time to try and hide them, so check regularly. Once you uncover the sigils, use the night shift database to decide which demon you're dealing with, and use that knowledge to create the mark. The steps are simple. Add the reagent to the embalming mixture. Uncover the sigils. Build the mark and place it on the body. Then, when you're certain, burn it in the retort.
Can't hold anything else. Hello?
Hello. Rebecca? Rebecca?
What the?
help me?
I'm missing something. All right. Yeah.
There we go. There we go.
Yo, I thought you'd be hiding at Billy's place. Your dad's been a total fucking spaz. We're heading down to the beach in just a sec. Grab your kit and get down. The party's gonna start without you.
Missing something.
Thank you.
right.
It's your grandma. I need you to let me in, sweetie. Don't you love your grandma? It's so cold out here. Love to come in. Let me in, Rebecca.
Let me in, you little bitch!
There we go.
right. There we go. Thank you. There we go. Right.
I miss you so much.
I don't care about anything anymore.
I don't want to be here without you.
Get me out of here!
Please, just...
They're gonna kill me!
I love you!
Stop it!
Thank you. I'm missing something. Anything else?
Thank you.
identifying a demonic entity is a delicate balance. The further you are from possession, the more time you have. The closer you are, the more the demon will make itself known, allowing you the information to guess its name and the body it's bound to. The only way I've found to tell how far along a possession is on your own is to scribble on a piece of paper. Don't think about it. Just scribble. Look carefully. If you notice anything strange, it's starting to take hold. There's a notepad and a pencil on the desk in the front room. Checking from time to time can give an idea of how long you might have.
Where am I? What happened? Let me go! Hey! What are you doing?
Sorry. This is the only way.
Wait, no. Why are you doing this? Help me, please! Raymond! Raymond? Seriously? Raymond? Hiding. Don't be scared.
Let me out, you little shit!
You fucking
burn!
You can never
fix what you've done!
See you soon.
Morning. It's nice not to be the one down there for a change.
Raymond?
I suppose a first name basis is in order.
Did I make it? Is it over?
For now. It's never really over. You've come a long way. It's a lot to learn.
I'm so glad I'm here.
I know it's disorienting. You'll get used to it. You should head home and get some rest. Every night can be different.
I think I'm fine.
Are you sure? You seem out of it.
Oh, I've just been waiting for so, so long.
What? What are you? Oh no, you chose the wrong demon. Rebecca!
Rebecca's not here, you fucking idiot!
Worthless. Watch your foolish boy and drink it as nuts from your pitiful frame.